Here are the top 8 features of macOS Sequoia coming this fall. And yes, that's my iPhone being mirrored on my Mac. From built-in window tiling, change your video background, which is now built into macOS, iPhone mirroring, like I said, upgrades to the Notes app, calendar and reminders, and more. As you're watching this, the macOS Sequoia public beta is available now for everyone to try. Try betas at your own risk, but macOS Sequoia will be available to everyone this fall. Our number one, the biggest new feature is iPhone mirroring in macOS. Just click the symbol down there in the dock and you'll automatically be connected to your iPhone as long as it's on the same iCloud account with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on. And now I can use my iPhone right here on my Mac. You can see I'm also using the tinting option in iOS 18. Even Instagram, the third-party app, has been tinted. I can open the Instagram app, scroll it right here on my Mac, answer DMs, and my iPhone can be in another room or in my pocket, and I can manage it all right here. If you want to go home using iPhone mirroring, just click the home bar at the bottom of the iPhone. You can swipe if you're using a trackpad with two fingers. If I need to search, I can click that right here at the bottom. And you'll also get notifications that pop up on your phone on your Mac, and it'll show up as native notifications. While you're using iPhone mirroring, you'll see this notification on your iPhone, which still remains locked. Someone can't use it until you unlock it with Face ID. You'll see that the iPhone is in use down here. But if you do unlock your iPhone, it will actually stop the mirroring here on your Mac. You'll see once you start using your phone and unlock it, it'll stop the mirroring. And you can hit try again, but you'll actually need to lock the screen on your phone in order to mirror it on your Mac. So I'll lock my iPhone screen here, and you'll see now it's connecting to the iPhone and it appears again. This will be great when using apps that are only on iPhone, don't have a Mac version, or something you can download, maybe like Instacart, and you don't have to get your phone out of pocket, and you can manage and use your phone all right here. All right, feature number two, window tiling is now built into macOS. If I long click on the green button on a window, you can see move and resize here, or even fill and arrange. So if I want to fill the left 50% of the window, I can do that. And if you have multiple windows open, now I can click and hold on that green button, and let's fill and arrange all these windows. There we go into a grid view. I'll click another one. Let's go 50% on that. And it allows you to quickly rearrange and move windows anywhere you'd like. You can also drag a window to the left or right side of the screen, and you'll see that kind of highlight outline, letting you know it's going to take up a 50%. I'll do that with a window over here. Let go, and now I'm tiled 50-50. Number three, you actually get more controls when you're going to share your screen here on your Mac. So let's say I'm in Riverside, I'm recording, and I want to share my screen here. I can share this window, and here in the menu bar, I actually see a preview of what I'm going to share. We still have the presenter overlay, which was there in macOS Sonoma. I can show myself small picture in picture. There I am popping out of this little circle down here. And also from macOS Sequoia, you can kind of overlay yourself on top of the screen sharing. But now in video calling apps, you actually get a preview before you share your window or screen so you know exactly what you're about to share. Also right here, you can recenter your camera angle just by clicking and dragging with that menu bar control. That's pretty cool. So not only do you get that presenter view when sharing your screen, but you can actually replace your background right here built into macOS. So here I've replaced it with just a light gradient. I can also go with different pictures or even choose one of my own images. Let's use this picture right here. And now I've decided my background here, so I don't have to do this in every video application like WebEx, Google Meet, and all of that. The background replacement is going to be built in right here in macOS. I can also adjust the zoom level and recenter myself around this background image. That's pretty cool. Number five, in macOS Sequoia, when you play video here on the internet like it's embedded in a web page, you're going to get more controls over that video. So here I'm playing a video on my website, beard.fm, and there's a new video viewer option right here. If I go into video viewer, it's going to focus here on the video, give me the HTML video controls, replacing whatever built-in website there might be. And I can go to picture in picture, change the playback speed, or AirPlay. And you can see it dimmed the website behind the video nicely. I'll go in picture here. And now this web video is playing in picture, I can place it in a different corner of the screen and click the X and it'll go back into the Safari window. This will work on other websites like here on CNN, you see there's a video playing right here. Well, I can click this symbol, go to video viewer, and now it's just focused here and I get those same HTML video controls as opposed to whatever built-in embed controls the website had before. I can put it in picture and like it's a native QuickTime video. Another Safari improvement is Safari Highlights and Summary. Now whenever I'm on a website, maybe it's a restaurant or hotel, and I can't find maybe the address I'm looking for, I can click this symbol and Safari is going to automatically highlight whether it's an address or contact info right here. In addition to those Safari highlights, when you have longer articles, you'll actually be able to summarize them right here in Safari. And if it's really long, you might even get a table of contents alongside the article summary. Pretty cool. All right, next up is improvements to Notes. One of the big new features coming to Notes, both on macOS and iOS 18, are voice transcriptions. So if I click this voice icon right here, I can actually start recording. This looks like the voice memo UI that you would see on an iPhone or iPad. But even as it's recording, you'll see there's a little transcript button down here. If I click that, it's actually going to start transcribing what I'm saying live as I record. This is going to be super useful if maybe you're in a lecture or at a conference and you want to record what's being said, but also have a text version. Well, now you can do it directly here in the Notes app. Then take that, run it through ChatGPT to summarize it, or use Apple Intelligence when that comes out later this year, or maybe next year. And you can do as many of those in a single note as you would like. I'll pause and hit done, and now I can play back that audio note right here, but you'll also see I can view the transcript. I can copy the transcript, I can find certain things by searching in the transcript, save it as an attachment, and more. In addition to transcripts, you'll actually be able to do math right here in Notes. Write a math problem and then an equal sign, and it's actually going to tell you the answer right here in the Notes without having to even open the calculator. You can even do currency conversions here in Notes by saying 25 USD to Euro, and it'll tell you the conversion right here in Notes. Lots of powerful tools just kind of behind the scenes via math and currency. And for formatting options, you make something a heading, you'll now actually be able to collapse the contents of everything under that heading. Same thing here, I can type something like voice notes, select that text, make it a heading, and now I can collapse that. And this can make really long notes easier to parse and read by collapsing and expanding sections as you need them. You also get more color options here in Notes, like right here, change the color of text, highlight, and more. And finally, number 8, if you use Apple's built-in calendar, but have always wanted to manage reminders in the same place as events, well, now you can do that. When I click on a date, I can create a new event here or create a new reminder. This will still sync with the Reminders app on your Mac. And if I create a reminder here, you'll see it appear on the calendar. If I change the date, clicking the eye icon, let me put it on Friday, you'll see that reminder actually moves to the calendar as well. If you expand the calendar view, you can actually turn off reminders and hide them from view or enable them. And you'll also be able to edit that reminder directly from the calendar. This will also be true for calendar on iOS and iPadOS. So those are the top 8 new features in macOS Sequoia. Again, the public beta is out. You can go to beta.apple.com if you'd like to try it. Again, beta's at your own risk. I just run it on secondary devices, not my main ones. But iPhone mirroring is live. You can use the highlights in Safari. Summaries in Safari does not appear to be live yet. We'll likely see that added in future betas, maybe closer to launch. But let me know, what's your favorite feature in macOS Sequoia, or what's something you hope was added? I didn't cover the passwords app in this video, but if you want to check out my iOS 18 beta features video, I'll put it right above here, and I talk about the dedicated passwords app, which is now on all the Apple devices. And if you'd like to see some of the updates that came to tvOS 18, a big one being Insight, where you can see actor info, and even add music to your Apple Music library that you hear in TV shows and movies, well, Apple TV Plus original content anyway, I put that video right up here. I'll link those down in the video description as well. Subscribe and hit that like button before you go, and thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.